Welcome to the DHS program video series on tips and tricks to matching data to the DHS final report using your statistical software program. Even though the DHS provides standardized variables and data sets, users often have trouble replicating tables in the final report. This video series covers the top 7 tips and tricks to successfully matching the DHS final report. In this video, we will walk through reasons 1 and 2, making sure that you are using the correct data file and the correct denominator. So the first question you should ask yourself is, am I using the correct data file? DHS collects data about households and the household members who reside there. And then, within these households, DHS interviews adult women and men. When interviewing the women, we also ask about each of her children. All of these data naturally form a hierarchy of data, but handling hierarchical data is complicated, so we make different files for the different units of analysis. If you are having trouble matching a final report number, the first thing to check is that you are using the correct data file. This may seem like an obvious mistake, but this is one of the most common errors people make. DHS has multiple data files that correspond to different units of analysis. Some of the most common data files are shown below. Make sure you are using the correct data file for your type of analysis. What's one quick way to check whether you are using the correct data file? Check your unit of analysis or denominator. Does it match the unit of analysis or denominator found in the final report? For example, let's look at antenatal and delivery care. Some antenatal and delivery care tables are based on women. For example, the percentage of women who had a birth in the last 5 years and received ANC for the last birth. And others are based on births or children. For example, the percentage of live births in the past 5 years that were delivered in a health facility. So which data file should you use to tabulate women? The IR file, limited to women who gave birth in the last 5 years. Which data file should you use to tabulate births in the last 5 years? The answer would be the KR or BR file, limited to the last 5 years. Another example, what if we wanted to calculate the percentage of children under age 5 who are stunted? This is a standard nutrition indicator among children under 5. So which file should we use? The KR and BR files include only those children whose mother was interviewed, or de facto mothers, while the PR file includes all children who were in the household, whether or not their mother was interviewed. The decision of which file to use should be made based on your analytical questions, as well as your data restrictions. Height and weight information is collected in the biomarker questionnaire, and the sample of all children in the PR file may be less biased than the sample of children of interviewed women in the KR file. So the DHS standard is to tabulate nutrition indicators like wasting and stunting in the PR file, but add characteristics linked from the KR file for children whose mothers were interviewed. Another question to ask if you aren't correctly matching DHS final report tables is, am I using the correct denominator or have I selected the correct cases? Even once you are using the correct file, you could still be using an inappropriate denominator or not properly selecting the correct cases. The best way to identify your denominator is to read the table heading and/or subheadings. For example, some tables have limited age ranges such as men 15 to 49 instead of all men interviewed. Or when looking at children, is the denominator all children under 5, last child born in the last 3 years, de jure or de facto? These are all questions you should be asking yourself when trying to match the correct denominator. Here's a table on prevalence, diagnosis, and prompt treatment of children with fever from the 2014-15 Rwanda DHS. Who is in this table? The table includes children under age 5, so it uses the KR file. Who is in the denominator of the first two columns? The first two columns include all children under age 5. Who is included in the last 7 columns? The denominator for the last 7 columns are children under age 5 with fever in the 2 weeks preceding the survey. The denominator is limited to children with fever because questions on diagnosis and prompt treatment were only asked for kids with fever in the 2 weeks preceding the survey. If you're trying to match the highlighted percentages, you will not properly match the table unless you restrict your analysis to children with fever. This video covered tips 1 and 2 for matching data and tables produced in a statistical software to the DHS final report. Please watch the subsequent videos to learn about the other reasons your data may not match the DHS final report table.